next, we'll install the PowerMate software that it's going to run the USB button, or the one button, that you'll be using with your studio. So you can follow the link that's in the setup guide. It's also just support.griffintechnology.com/product/PowerMate. So this is going to give you the button software. And this has a whole support page here. The software downloads aren't until further down the page. So if you scroll down until you get to the section that says downloads, this is where you're going to want to look. And you only want to download one of these files. And the one you're going to want to download currently is going to be this original USB PowerMate Manager version 3.1. And you notice here that it says for Mac OS X, 10.6 to 10.9. Even though your computer is most likely past version 10.9 of the operating system, you still want to download this. We've tested it, and this actually works more reliably than the newer version of the software that's here, for whatever reason. Not sure why that is. But go ahead and just download version 3.1. So you can click on download. That's going to download. And then you just install that. And once you have it installed, you can find the PowerMate software within the applications folder. And you can see here I have PowerMate. So I'm just going to double click on that. And it's telling me that PowerMate is an application downloaded from the internet. Are you sure you want to open it? I am sure. If it's not giving you the option to open it, if it says it's from an unidentified developer and it's not giving you the option to open, what you want to do is hold down the control key on the keyboard and then click on PowerMate and then go to open. And that's going to allow you to open that application. So this is all has to do with the security settings. So if you want to change it so this doesn't give you an error every time you try and open an application that's from an unidentified developer, watch the video that says System Preferences, and it'll show you in there how to sort of disable that. So I'm going to click on Open, and that's going to open up the PowerMate software. And so within here, you're probably going to see a few different items listed along here. So right now mine is set up correctly as it is here. You'll probably see a bunch of extra things that are set in here. So to give you a better sense of what this is going to look like, I'm just going to delete the things that I have already. And this will most likely not be called OBS. It'll most likely be called default or something like that. So when you're in PowerMate, you essentially just want to delete everything out of here in this list. So if there are things listed here, you can just click on them and hit delete on the keyboard and just delete everything that's in here until you're left with this default item set and global beneath that. So you can't delete these. They have to stay there. So once everything is out of this list, if you click on global and then come up here where it says add item, you want to go down to add trigger. And this is basically giving the button a command. So when you press the silver USB button, it's telling it what to do. So you're adding a press here, so that's fine. You want to leave it as press. So where it says trigger on, you want to make sure it just says normal press. All these other options you can leave alone. Once press is added, if you go back to add item, and then go down in this menu to where it says key press. Key press is going to be added underneath this press, and this will let you define what the press of the button does on the computer. So we want to set this, we want the user or the key press to be user defined, and then we want this to be the space bar. So every time you press the silver button, it's acting like a space bar. So go ahead and click on set, and you can see in here it's going to say press desired key combo. So on your keyboard then, just press the space bar. And then it's going to set that to space. So now every time you press the silver USB button, it's going to act as a click of the space bar. And now that these options are set, you can even test this out. If you have your USB button hooked up already, you can select a folder or your Macintosh HD icon out here and just click on the button. And that will bring up the information for whatever you're selected on, so you know it's working. So just go ahead and click on the button and test that out. And if it works, then you're good to go.